Hello students, today we can see the topic biomolecules. There is a wide variety of living organisms in our biosphere, isn't it? And as you all know, all the living organisms are made up of the basic unit called the cell. The cell is surrounded by the plasma membrane, and inner to the plasma membrane is the fluid matrix called the cytoplasm. The cytoplasm is formed of various elements and compounds. Now, if we want to know whether all the living organisms are formed of the same chemicals, that is, same elements and compounds, we have to do elemental analysis, just like as we do in chemistry. So, for doing the elemental analysis, we have to take a plant tissue or an animal tissue or a microbial paste. And when we do the elemental analysis in that, we can find a variety of elements present in the tissue like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, magnesium, potassium, sodium, etc. Isn't it? So all these elements will be there in the tissue, whether it is a plant tissue or animal tissue or a microbial paste. Now, if we take a piece of the earth crust or a little amount of soil and again do the same elemental analysis, we can find that the same elements which are present in the living tissue will be seen in the earth crust also, or in that soil also. Okay, so we can say that whatever elements are present in the earth crust, the same type of elements will be present in the living system also. Okay, but a closer examination gives us that the amount of carbon and hydrogen with respect to the other elements will be higher in living organism than the earth crust. Okay, a closer examination reveals that the amount of carbon and hydrogen with respect to the other elements is found to be higher in the living organism than in the earth crust. This is a comparison of elements present in the non-living and the living matter. So you can see here all these elements are present both in the earth crust as well as the human body. Only the percentage of these elements will be differing. Okay. How to analyze the chemical composition of a tissue? So if we want to find out the chemical nature or the elements and compounds present in any tissue, we have to perform chemical analysis. So for this, we have to take a living tissue, whether it is a plant tissue or animal tissue. Plant tissue, for example, a piece of vegetable can be taken. For animal tissue, a piece of liver can be taken or any other such tissue can be taken. And it should be grinded in trichloroacetic acid. So which acid is used for grinding the tissue? Trichloroacetic acid is used. Okay, and we have to take a mortar and pestle, and in this mortar and pestle we have to grind the tissue. This is the mortar and pestle which is used to grind the tissue. So in a mortar and pestle, we are grinding the tissue with the trichloroacetic acid. Now why trichloroacetic acid is used? Because it can precipitate the larger molecules and the smaller molecules can dissolve in it. So we are using trichloroacetic acid to grind the tissue. Okay. And after grinding, we will get a thick slurry. And this thick slurry should be filtered now. So, for filtering, we have to use a cheesecloth or cotton. Okay, through that we have to pour that thick slurry. So, when we pour it, we will be getting two fractions. What are the two fractions we can get? One is the acid soluble pool or the filtrate, and another is the acid insoluble fraction or the retentate. Okay, so these are the two fractions which we can get it. One is the acid soluble pool or the filtrate which we get below, that is, which will be passing through the cheesecloth or the cotton. Okay, that is the filtrate or the acid soluble pool, and the other one is the acid insoluble fraction, or we can say it as the retentate, which will be retained over the cheesecloth. Okay. We analyze the acid soluble pool, we can find thousands of organic compounds in it. We can use various separation techniques to separate a compound from the other compound. So thousands of compounds are there in the acid soluble pool, isn't it? So we have to use various separation techniques to separate a particular compound from the mixture of compounds. In chemistry, you used to do various analysis to find out what type of salt it is. Isn't it like that? Here also various separation techniques can be used so that we can isolate and separate a particular compound from the mixture of other compounds. Okay, then various analytical techniques can be followed so that it gives us an idea about the molecular formula and the structure of that compound. Now, what is meant by biomolecules? Bio means living. Molecules present in the living organism or the living tissue can be said to be as biomolecules. Or even we can say that all carbon compounds that we get from the living tissue is called the biomolecules. Okay, all the carbon compounds we get from living tissue is said to be as biomolecules. Now, whether the living tissue is made up of only organic compounds, whether inorganic elements or compounds are there, of course, that is also present, isn't it? So to know that, what are the inorganic substances, inorganic compounds which are present in the living tissue, we have to perform a destructive technique. Okay, so here you should know what is this wet weight. The weight of the living tissue is said to be as wet weight. Okay, when we take a living tissue, it will be having more amount of water in it. So the weight of that living tissue, we can say it as wet weight. And when we dry it, what happens? The water from that tissue will evaporate. So now if you take the weight, we will get the dry weight. So what is dry weight? The weight of the tissue after the water evaporates is said to be dry weight. Okay, now when we fully burn this dried tissue, we will get the ash. Okay, so what is this ash? When the dried tissue is fully burned, we can get the ash. Now when we analyze this ash, it contains inorganic elements in it. Okay, various inorganic elements are present in the ash. This is a list of inorganic substances present in the living tissue. So the inorganic substances include sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, water, and even inorganic compounds like sodium chloride, calcium carbonate, sulfate, phosphate, etc. Ash contains elements like calcium, magnesium, etc., and compounds like sulfate, phosphate, etc. Okay, inorganic elements like calcium, magnesium are there, and inorganic compounds like sulfate, phosphate, etc. are there. So all this can be found in the acid soluble fraction also. Okay, so elemental analysis gives the elemental composition of the living tissue, and when we analyze the compounds, we can get what kind of organic and inorganic compounds are there in the living tissue. Okay, now whatever compounds are there in the living tissue, based on a chemistry point of view, we can identify the various functional groups like aldehydes, ketones, aromatic compounds, etc. And in a biological point of view, we can classify them as amino acids, nucleotide bases, fatty acids, etc. Okay.